The symptoms of seasonal flu and the symptoms of H1N1 are very similar. H1N1 does have a little bit more tummy symptoms like nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea than the seasonal flu does, but this is only in children. The symptoms include the very sudden onset of fever, often as high as 104, body aches, cough, and congestion. Both viruses are respiratory viruses. The children at highest risk are going to be those who have pre-existing health conditions, chronic health conditions like diabetes or sickle cell disease or asthma, and then children who are under 6 months of age, and then really any child is at risk for serious complications. That's why we want as many children as possible to come in and be seen and to receive a flu vaccine if they can. If your child displays flu-like symptoms, you want to be seen as soon as you possibly can, but you have about a 48-hour window during which you can receive antiviral medications if they are warranted for your child. So it's a good idea to be seen within 48 hours of the onset of the fever, and certainly if you ever see shortness of breath or any respiratory symptoms with your child that concern you, you'd want to be seen right away. If your child is confirmed as positive for either the seasonal or the H1N1 flu, you would expect to see fever as high as 104 for as many as 5 to 10 days. You also would expect to see cough and congestion for several weeks. The body aches are typically present only in the beginning and when the fever is present, and then tummy symptoms like nausea or vomiting can be present in the early days as well. If your child or anyone in your family has had a positive confirmed exposure to H1N1 or seasonal flu, usually the symptoms start very quickly within the first 48 hours, but can take as long as 7 days to show. If your child has not received either the H1N1 vaccine or the seasonal flu vaccine, you need to make an appointment with your child's provider to make sure that they can receive at the very least their seasonal flu vaccine, and your child might also be eligible to receive the H1N1 vaccine at that time. The H1N1 vaccine is currently being administered by the local health departments and most of the primary care pediatric providers in our area. You can receive both vaccines, the H1N1 and the seasonal flu vaccine, at the same time if one is the live vaccine and one is the inactivated vaccine, or if both are the inactivated vaccine. You cannot receive both nasal spray versions on the same day. They need to be separated by a period of approximately 4 weeks or more. If your child receives the nasal spray vaccine, either of H1N1 or of seasonal flu, there's a mild possibility, a slight possibility, 0.2%, that they could spread the virus to someone who is severely immune compromised, such as someone who's had a bone marrow transplant or someone who has AIDS. They can be around people who are asthmatics on steroid medications, people who have HIV disease but do not have AIDS, and people who have milder degrees of immune compromise. If your child receives the seasonal flu vaccine and or the H1N1 vaccine, it still is possible for them to get the flu. It does decrease the risk significantly by sometimes as much as 70 to 90% of them getting the flu. Also, if they get the flu after having received the vaccine, they're going to have a much milder course with their illness and much less risk for serious complications. The country, the government, is distributing the H1N1 vaccine, and each state has the opportunity to determine who they want to receive the vaccine first. The state of Georgia has determined that 2 to 4-year-olds are at the highest risk for complications from H1N1 disease and also tend to spread the virus faster than other age groups. It is for this reason that South Coast has determined that our vaccine will first be distributed to those 2 to 4-year-olds who are at high risk for complications. Following the administration to those kids, we will administer the vaccine to other 2 to 4-year-olds, and if we have vaccine left over, then we will open it up to all of our other patients who are eligible to receive the vaccine.